In this video, I will show you more about the MetaTrader platform, especially if you are a beginner trader, and I will give you some tips that you need to know before starting trading with expert advisors. So this is how the MetaTrader platform looks like after you install it. And I have selected MetaTrader for the purpose of this course and for most of my courses because it is the most common platform for trading. It allows algorithmic trading, which is very important, and it is free. So the brokers pay to the MetaQuote company and the brokers provide the platform to us for free. We don't pay any monthly fees, charges, and so on. What we pay to the brokers is the spread. And this is the difference between the bid and the ask price. So for the beginner traders, when we buy an asset, we buy it on the ask price, or this is the more expensive price. And when we sell the asset, we sell it on the bid price, which is the cheaper price. So for example, if I buy one trading lot at the moment at the price of 118.60 and the price rises to 119.60, this will be 100 pips of a profit. If I close the position at that moment, I will be closing it on the bid price. So the broker will benefit that difference between the buy and the sell prices. And this is very normal. And it is important when you are trading with expert advisors. And the other cost that we pay to the broker, this is the swap. So the swap comes if we hold our position overnight. So if I buy euro dollar, for example, today, and I hold the position overnight and I close the trade tomorrow, I will be charged a swap, which is a fee that the broker takes if it transfers the trade for the next day. It is the same thing if you sell, but some brokers will give you actually positive swap. So if they hold your position overnight, you may benefit out of that. Let's see how much is the swap, for example, for euro dollar. If I right click over the market watch, over the euro dollar, and I click on specification, you will see that I have some details about the asset. And if I scroll down, I can see that I have a swap long negative and I have a swap short positive. Which means that if I keep my short trade overnight, I will have some positive swap out of that. Okay, and in this lecture, you will see a PDF attached with some basic terminology about the trading, which will help you learn all of these terms faster. So in the market watch, we see all of the assets that the broker offers you. And if you don't see too many, what you can do is right click anywhere on the market watch and check show all. This will display more assets that are provided by the broker. And of course, it depends on the broker that you are using and on the type of account you're using. So this broker, for example, offers more assets on its real account, which you will see later in the course. But in this course, I will focus on the pound dollar, which I believe you will be able to find with all of the brokers. And actually, the pound dollar is the third most traded currency pair. First is euro dollar, second is dollar yen, and on the third spot is pound dollar. However, in most of my courses, I include different strategies for different assets. And if you have already many of my courses, you will have expert advisors for euro dollar, dollar yen, euro yen, euro pound. So you will have a great diversification of your risk by trading different assets. Now for this course, I will include different strategies for the pound. So you will not rely on one single strategy, on one single expert advisor. And still this way, you will have an excellent risk diversification and you will see that a little bit later in the course. So this is the market watch. If you want to trade any of the assets, all you need to do is to right click and go to new order. This is from where you can execute an order. You can set the volume, how much you want to trade, the stop loss, take profit. If you want to execute the market price at the moment, you can just sell or buy. Or if you want to use a pending order, you can do it from right over here. Select what type of pending order you want to do and select the price at which you want to buy or to sell. Now, I'm not doing manual trading and I won't be executing trades manually. You will see how I do it all with the expert advisors, which we will put later in the course in the expert advisors tab. So in the Navigator, you will see that we have the accounts. This is where you will see your account that you opened with the broker. If you have a demo, if you have a live account, then we have the different indicators which you can use for your strategies. And then we have the expert advisors, which I will show you how to put on your MetaTrader just in the next lectures. Okay, and below we have some scripts that are useful for different purposes when you're using MetaTrader, but I'm not going into details about that. Below is the trading terminal where we will see the open trades, the closed trades. We will have account history where we'll see all trades that opened and closed. And I have opened a demo account of $50,000, which are virtual money. So if you open a demo account and you lose, no matter how are you doing manual trading or with expert advisors, don't worry, these are virtual money. You won't own anything to the broker. You can always restart your account and practice. This is the best thing when you have a demo account, that you are actually trading, you have access to the market, you can practice, and you are not losing anything. Don't hurry risking real money until you're confident with the system, until you feel satisfied with the strategies, with the robots that you're using, not just from this course, but any other strategies that you learn. Make sure to practice and make sure to master it before risking real money on the market. In the middle of the screen, you see the charts and you can modify those. By default, I see four. I can right click and select tile windows, which will split it in four charts. And I can close them if I want. I can leave just one. And as I've said in this course, I will be trading the pound dollar. So for the expert advisors, it really doesn't matter if you have indicators over the chart or not. What I like to do is just to remove the indicators from the chart. And as well, I remove the grid behind, so I can right click over the chart, go to properties, and from common, I can uncheck show grid. As well, I can change the colors of the candlesticks, or I can leave them the way they are. Doesn't really matter. One more time for algorithmic trading. One more time, I will go to indicators list because I didn't remove the moving average. Here it is. All right, and last thing, I will uncheck one click trading because I don't need it. So this is the default chart and I can actually save it as a template. I will right click over the chart, go to template, save template, and I will save it as empty template. All right, so this way I know that whenever I want to have an empty template, I can easily do that. So for example, if I open another chart for pound dollar, right click over it and go to chart window, I can right click over it template and I will select empty template. And you can see it's empty, no any indicators, no grid, no one click trading. So this way you can modify your trading platform any way that you want. As well, you can switch to bar charts or to a line chart, which is the very same thing, but with candlesticks we have more visual representation of the price by having the candlesticks colored according whether they were bullish or whether they were bearish. In simple words, if they were positive or if they were negative. And if I put my mouse on the closing of any of the candlesticks, you will see that I have five values: high, low, close, and volume. So these four values form the historical data which we are using in algorithmic trading to create expert advisors and to backtest expert advisors. And the current price for pound dollar is 131.26, and all the rest that you see before that is called historical data. And in the next section, I will show you how we use this historical data to create strategies and expert advisors and to see how they performed until the moment. And along the course, I will show you more about MetaTrader platform so you will feel comfortable with it. And by the end of the course, you will know exactly what you need to do in order to test expert advisors and to see some profits into your account. All right, thank you very much for watching. If you have enjoyed that video and you are ready to use MetaTrader, click on the like button and subscribe to our channel so you will see some more of our free content on YouTube. Have a wonderful day.